Tutu's Dream by Judith White Marcellini. Aloha! Welcome to the island of Hawaii. Tutu and her grandchildren, Leilani, Kimo, and Little Kai, were having a picnic on the beach. Her big picnic basket overflowed with favorite foods she had prepared. "This ahi poke is yummy, Tutu," said Leilani. "May I have some more, please?" "Me too," said Kimo, passing his plate. Just then, he noticed Tutu wasn't smiling. "We're all having so much fun," said Kimo. "Why do you look sad?" "Oh, I keep thinking about a dream I had last night," she answered. "In my dream, I saw the ocean. There were big schools of colorful fish with many different shapes and sizes. It was the way I remember the ocean when I was a child. So many fish, so beautiful." "Why would such a dream make you sad?" asked Leilani. "Because now I look at the ocean and I see it no longer as rich as when I was a child," answered Tutu. "There are fewer fish and not so many of the great big ones that I loved. I am sad because we have lost something beautiful, something that made me happy. And I am afraid that when you're my age, there will be even fewer fish." "How sad." "Where did the fish go?" asked Leilani. "Well, many were caught for food. We all like to eat fish. Me too. When I was a girl, we did eat some fish every week. Back then, there were plenty. We only took what we needed and didn't waste any. But today, there are more people. More people eat more fish. And people outside Hawaii buy our colorful reef fish, which are sent far away from here for home aquariums." "Is there anything we can do so we have lots of fish again?" asked Leilani. "Well, people could stop eating fish," said Little Kai. "That's sure not going to happen," said Kimo. "Imagine getting the whole world to stop eating fish. I don't think you can even make me stop." "Not eating fish? Yes, that would be a pretty drastic plan," agreed Tutu. "But there is another way. So tell us about this plan. Is it some kind of magic?" "No, it's not magic. It's pretty simple, really. Here's what we can do." Then Tutu reached into her basket and pulled out some paper and colored markers. She began to draw a map. "Here, along the coast of Hawaii, we can set up some safe places for fish. In these places, fish would be protected and allowed to grow to full size." "Uh-oh," said Kimo. "My uncle might not like that. He's a fisherman, and he's teaching me how to fish. Maybe he fishes in some of those places." "Let me go on," said Tutu. "You can see that there are lots of big open spaces between the safe places. Fishermen could still fish along most of the coastline. That should please your uncle. In the safe places, the fish would live to grow big and have lots of babies. After a number of years, there would be lots of fish in the safe places. What happens next is kind of magical. There would be so many fish in the safe places that they spill over into the big open spaces where people fish. Then, fishermen like you and your uncle would have better fishing than ever." "That does seem like magic. Too simple to really work," said Kimo. "Why can't we just do that for a few years and keep changing where the safe places are?" "That sounds good, but doesn't work. Oahu and other places tried it. Not long after you open a safe place back up, most of the larger fish get taken before they have a chance to lay enough eggs." "So we need the safe places to stay in the same locations?" asked Kimo. "Yes, just like parks. It's an idea that works. That way we get better fishing forever, said Tutu. And it isn't magic, Tutu told him. This has worked in Australia, California, Mexico, Palau, and other places. But the plan does take effort. It's not so easy. What's not easy? Asked Leilani. First, working together to set up the safe places. Then working hard to keep the places safe. People will have to trust the plan and be patient. It will take some time for the fish to grow and produce lots more, said Tutu. But that plan does sound better than not eating fish at all, piped up little Kai. I like watching fish, but I also really like to eat them. They are yummy. I like the idea that someday I will be able to see an ocean as beautiful as the one in your dream, filled with fish like when you were a child, Leilani joined in. Can we still play in the safe places, Tutu? Of course. We can go swim and play and snorkel and surf there. And Kimo's uncle can come too and fish on either side, said Tutu. I like the idea that my uncle and I could fish in most places and catch more fish like in the old days, said Kimo. All we'd have to do is change where we fish a little bit. We like to see you smiling, Tutu. This plan makes you happy. And that makes us happy, said Leilani. Now pass me some more ahi poke. It sure is good. Dedicated to our children, that they may enjoy the abundance and natural beauty of our oceans as our ancestors found them. E mālama ina koa o ke kai.